We thank God for another morning when we can come and bring devotions. Let us pray. Father, we thank you for your blessings. We thank you, Lord, for watching over us throughout the past night. And Lord, you have brought us to a new day, to the beginning of a new day. Lord, we thank you and we praise you because we realize it is no goodness of our own why we are here, but it's because of your grace and because of your mercy, because of your love. Father, we just want to thank you for today. And as we go into this devotion, Lord God, let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in your sight, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. Let some soul be blessed today, Lord God, and let your word resonate in some spirit for a new beginning. It's time to cross over. Bless us together, I pray. Now I thank you for this privilege to bring your word. In Jesus' name, amen. Happy 8th anniversary to Sister Angela and Joy Gospel Radio FM family. We are all in this together and celebrating the 8th anniversary. I remember, I think it was the 5th anniversary when I brought a devotion that said, "Hitherto has the Lord helped us." And he has brought us from the 5th now to the 8th, and we want to give God thanks. New beginnings, it's time to cross over. Joshua 1, 1 and 2 is where I'm reading from. Joshua chapter 1, verses 1 and 2 from the New King James Version. Now, after the death of Moses, the servant of the Lord, it came to pass that the Lord spoke to Joshua, the son of Nun, Moses' assistant, saying, "Moses, my servant, is dead. Now, therefore, arise, go over this Jordan, you and all this people, to the land which I am giving to them, the children of Israel." God told Joshua to arise and go over Jordan with all the people. The land was already given to them, but they had to cross over Jordan to possess it. Your blessing, your promise is on the other side of whatever seems to block your move. You must move. You mean I have to cross another obstacle? Yes, because your promise is on the other side. You have to arise and cross over to possess. God is waiting for you to make up your mind. God will do a new thing. I just heard Pastor Monique say it. God will do a new thing. He will make a way in the wilderness, streams of water in the desert, and a path through the Red Sea, through the Jordan. Whatever your obstacle is, God will make a way. The land, the new place, is where you have not been before. It is a new beginning. Leaving the old behind, leaving the comfortable behind, leaving the stagnancy behind, leaving the familiar place behind, and moving to a new place. Hallelujah. However, the Jordan is before you. It's not easy to cross over. In Mark chapter 4, Jesus told the disciples, "Let us cross over to the other side." He did not tell them they would encounter a storm. He just said, "Let us cross over." When we make up in our mind to cross over to receive our promise, we must get up. We must change whatever we are doing, move from a place of the familiar, of comfortable, and go forward. When we cross over, we receive the promise. Therefore, when we encounter obstacles, we must remember God's word. He said, "Let us cross over." That means he is with us. If we don't stop, if we don't give up, we have the guarantee that we will cross over. In Joshua chapter, Ark of the Covenant and the priests, because we have not passed this way before, it's a new beginning. We know the Ark of the Covenant represented the presence of God. Jordan was overflowing its banks, but Joshua had a word from God. Hallelujah. If we focus on Jordan, we will take our eyes off of God. We cannot afford to lose our focus. That's why Peter sang. He was walking on water, but he took his eyes off of God and he looked at the boisterous waves. We can't afford to look at the Jordan overflowing its banks. We can't afford to look at the obstacle that might be in our way. God has told us to arise, cross over, and possess. Glory to God. And when we have that promise, we can come across, cross over any obstacle. If we keep our eyes on God, when we are crossing over into new territory, our eyes must be on Jesus. The people were to follow, not to go before the ark. Just so, we must allow God to go before us, to lead us, make him our priority. We must follow his guidance and his instructions because we cannot cross over on our own. We have to keep our eyes on Jesus, follow his instructions, follow his guidance, and make him priority in our lives. We must listen for his voice as we pray and read his word. God must be first. I just heard the Holy Spirit say, this is not just for JGRFM. There is somebody who needs to arise and cross over from where you are to your promise, to possess what God has promised you. So this is not just for JGRFM. It's a new beginning for somebody this morning. You must arise, cross over to possess. But you have to keep your eyes on Jesus. Joshua told the people, sanctify yourselves. They had to go through the religious and the ritualistic sanctification. But 1 Peter 3:15 tells us to sanctify the Lord in our hearts. I remember last week I did a devotion, The Healthy Heart. Our hearts must be sanctified in order to cross over your Jordan and possess your promise. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Sanctify the Lord God in your hearts. In our hearts is where we have to sanctify him. Our hearts must be sanctified for the new beginnings and the crossover. God cannot do a new thing in an old heart, in an old mindset. We must arise. Hallelujah. Arise from where you are. Sanctify the Lord God in your heart. Get a new heart. Our hearts must be sanctified for the new beginning and the crossover. That's why Joshua told the people, sanctify yourselves, for tomorrow the Lord will do wonders among you. We must declutter our hearts. I heard the Holy Spirit say that yesterday I was writing this devotion. We must declutter our hearts. Sometimes we have too many things going on. We must declutter our hearts and remove everything that is unlike God so that he alone can dwell in our hearts. We sanctify ourselves for new beginnings and a crossover to possess the promise that God has given to us. Where is the promise? The promise is in his word. Every promise in the book is mine, the songwriter says. Every scripture, every chapter, every verse, every line. We have the promise, but sometimes we sit back and we wait for God to do something. God is waiting on us to arise and cross over to possess. New beginnings. It's time to cross over. Face the Jordan. Sanctify yourself. Focus on God. Trust God's instructions and cross over into the new place. Father, we thank you this morning. Hallelujah. 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 We thank you, God, for a new beginning this morning. Not only for JGRFM, but for somebody I'm hearing this morning. God has a new beginning But you need to arise and cross over to possess. God, I thank you this morning for your word. Thank you for your presence. I thank you, Lord, for Sister Angela and this radio station. Continue to keep your hand upon this station, Lord God. Continue to lead and guide Sister Angela, Father, and help her to walk in obedience to you, mighty God. Use her for your honor and for your glory. So many souls are being blessed by this station, God. Give her your guidance and your direction and help her to walk in obedience. Father, remove self from us this morning and help us to sanctify you in our hearts that we might cross over to a new beginning. Bless everyone here, Lord God, and JGRFM. Make us a blessing. In Jesus' name.